Hello, and we are going to be making some Welsh cakes today. So we got the ingredients right here. We're going to be cooking them and baking them to make some Welsh cakes.
So step number one is turning on the gas so we can heat up the bake stone. So do you want to do the dial by there? You have to push it in and turn it round. All the way around, you don't want to burn yourself. And then step back and push the button to ignite.
So step number two, we just need to prep some butter.
That's right, you need 4 ounces of butter, okay?
Four?
4 ounces.
Okay, just a tiny bit.
Might be a bit more than that, but...
So much?
Okay.
Oops.
It's all right. Okay, so
that's 2.
That's 0.2, so you're gonna need a lot more than that.
More?
Yeah, loads. It's probably about half a block. Okay, so step 3, we have to measure the flour. You need 8 ounces. So twice as much flour, okay? How much have you got there? So keep going, you need 8. Nearly, a bit more.
There you go. Step number 4, you hold the flour into the butter like this. All of it.
That's right.
Like that. Step number 5, we have to, just like with the butter and the flour, you just need to like squeeze it in into the flour, the butter into the flour like this.
That's it.
So that's how you can make the Welsh cake, more Welsh cakes. And you need 80 on that thing.
8 ounces of flour, yeah?
Yeah.
That's it, and you rub it together until it's nice and fine like little breadcrumbs.
Yeah.
It's a good workout, isn't it?
Yeah, it actually feels nice.
Does it?
Yeah,
it actually
feels
nice. Is it very therapeutic?
Yeah, it feels like sand. It's been squished up with a ton of butter. It's going to be taken over right now.
Just finishing it off, he's done very well. Do you want to come and show them what you've done?
Yeah, I'll show you what I've done.
So it's like that.
Yeah, it's like nice and fluffy.
And like little crumbs, just like that. See, he's done it really well, but I'm just getting some of the lumps out. It's just important not to work it too much.
Yeah, if you work it too much, the cakes will not taste that good. It'll taste really hard.
So what are we doing next, Liam?
We're going to be pouring some sugar in it.
Okay, so how much sugar do we need? Do you know?
No.
3 ounces.
Three.
Just 3, 3 0. So that'd be 3.0, okay? Okay. Careful.
Almost
there we go. And then the next thing that we need to add is the sultanas. So do you want to grab them off the work surface?
Yeah, I'll get them off. If I can reach them, I can.
That's it. So before you weigh the sultanas, you need to reset the scale to 0. Okay. So if you push that one, perfect.
Take the bowl on?
No, you want the bowl on. It's incorporating the bowl's weight. So take the peg off. If you lift the clasp on the back, look, if you flick that up, that's it.
Oh, that's a good one.
And we need, well, they say 3 sometimes, but I like to be cheeky and chuck in an extra ounce, so let's go 4. I like fruit.
Yeah.
Not 4 sultanas, 4 ounces.
Huh?
4 ounces, not 4 sultanas.
Oh, 4 ounces!
Sorry. That was my bad instruction, wasn't it?
Oh, Not too much.
You haven't? Look, you got 0.6.
So how much do I need?
4.0.
4.0. Okay, 4.0 it is.
So that's 2.5. Do you see that little dot there? So you've got, there you are, 4. Tidy.
Okay, so right now we need to stir this gently.
You need to mix these ingredients in with the breadcrumbs.
Yeah, so you have to pour it in, then mix it.
Yeah. And then gently mix it all together.
Like this. This is how you do it.
That's it, mix it right up so you get even amount of sugar and sultanas in the mixture.
Yep, like this. So you need all the sugar gone. You do?
Yeah, you do.
You don't want any lumps in it.
That's correct.
Apart from don't want any sugar on the sultanas. Not sugar. Because otherwise it'll be sugary.
Right, so that's all mixed in lovely. So we want to add a little bit of salt, so a pinch of salt. So if you just shake a little bit of salt in. Keep going, bit more. Bit more. Bit more. Better. Okay, and then we want the mixed spice. So do you want to get that off the counter?
Yep.
So that the other one's open already. Lee, that one's open.
Okay, this one.
Yeah.
Okay.
So traditionally you don't tend to put mixed spice in Welsh cakes, but Auntie Spoon always does because she thinks they taste that little bit extra yummy.
Extra, like, yeah. So yeah, you put a tiny bit in there.
Well, if you ask me, I would chuck all of it in.
Oh, all the entire bowl in there?
What's left? Show them how much is left.
So there's not much left, we have to chuck everything in there.
I would, yeah, personally.
Yeah, if it's like up to... like there, you have to chuck everything in it.
I like a good bit of mixed spice.
What? So put everything in it?
All of it in. Go for it. Go mad. Okay, now mix that up.
Okay.
And you're careful not to lose it, otherwise you're not going to get as many Welsh cakes. And so mix it in and it'll be a little brown colour. Just be gentle. Otherwise you'd be wearing it. And then people might eat you instead.
Yeah. Okay. Next up, we have to crack an egg into here, but this is really tricky. So basically, I do that.
You got it.
Then you open it. Okay.
Yeah, and you've got to be... So if you put your fingers in the hole and then pull them apart.
Like that.
And get all of the... Dude, that is perfect. There's not a single bit of shell in there. I think that deserves a high five. Yes.
Then
egg cracker master. Look at that.
Get put in the bin then.
Perfect.
Okay, I need to wash my hands.
Is that the first time you've cracked an egg?
No.
Oh, I mean, apart from the time you cracked one with me and it went over the unit. Is that the first time you've done it properly?
No.
No? Well, I shouldn't be so surprised then, but the last time I saw this man crack an egg, it went all over the unit.
Yeah, so half of it went on the unit, half of it went in the bowl.
Yeah.
The next step, you have to like... put the fork in the middle, like the orange bit, so I have to mix it up with the rest of the egg.
That's right.
So basically like this.
Let me show them.
You have to mix it up like this. Keep mixing it until it gets all like, until it gets all big.
That's right.
Just keep doing it.
So look, bro. And now we need to add that to the mixture. So if you pour all of that into the bowl.
What bowl?
This one.
Okay.
So pour the egg in there. I'll take the fork.
Yeah, I'll pour this into here.
Yep, pour it in.
And I have not even done this on a single video yet. It's my first time me doing
it. It's the first time you've ever made Welsh cakes. All by yourself. And on a video, yeah. And now you need to mix that all in together until it forms a dough. So if you just stir it in, that's it, and eventually it'll start clumping together into a dough, okay?
Then, she's going to be taking over again.
I'm taking over, I'm just finishing it off, where are you going?
This is what I have to do.
So I'm just squishing it in like that, look, to try and get it into a big ball. Do you see how it's sticking together? Yeah?
Yep.
Sometimes I find it easier to use my hands, but if you don't want messy hands, then we can just use a spoon, but you've got to just push it in like that. Do you see that?
Mm-hmm.
And you're gonna have some stuck on your spoon. So I might just finish this off with my hands. So if you clump it together, like that, look.
Peace.
And then you've got a big lump of dome. Just like that. And then we need to roll this out. Okay?
Next step, but though it's kind of messy, but you have to pour flour all over the unit.
That's right. Well, put it all down. Okay, then roll the rolling pin in it.
Put more flour.
Okay.
Then you roll the rolling pin there.
Just to cover the rolling pin, because you don't want it sticking to the Welsh cake dough. Okay? And if you just spread the flour on the work surface a bit.
Okay, then
use your hands and push the flour on the work surface. You're going to get dirty hands now. So a bit like this, look. Okay? Then you need to get the dough out of the bowl. So pick it up with your hands.
It's sticky.
Yeah, it will be sticky. That's why you need to put flour on the unit. It stops it sticking. And put it down. And just turn it over in the flour. Yeah. So just
squishy the flour.
Well, that's it. You don't want it to stick. So it's good just to cover it
up. Then you roll it.
You do roll it. But like I said, don't be too hard with the rolling pin.
No, if you be too hard, it'll be more flatter.
They'll be like pancakes. And we don't want pancakes. So if you put the rolling pin on top and then just carefully push down. A bit more weight than that. There you go. And just try and keep even pressure. Cool. And then if you spin it around a bit.
Then you roll it there.
Put some flour on top. That's it. And then roll it the other way.
Yeah, if you put some flour on top, it'll be good.
Yeah, it stops it sticking and getting wrecked. Okay. Keep going.
Next part, you have to push down on here so you can get the things.
That's it. So push down and twist.
Then you have stuck one.
No, it's fine. If you just get it here and then tap on top, it'll come out, okay?
Yeah.
So get as close to the next one as possible so you don't waste. That's it. Cool. You can pick it up with your hands, otherwise you'll wreck the shape of it. Come here, watch. Take the dough from around the outside and then you can lift it up.
Then you put it there.
Be careful, otherwise it's going to fall apart.
Yeah, it can fall apart sometimes. If you don't be careful, it'll fall apart, really easily.
Cool.
Then you have to... You have these Welsh cakes, but this is the really, 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 really hard part. So if you have one of these, don't put your hands on it, it'll be really hot.
So you want to test it first, so put one Welsh cake on begin with. And then it's basically a waiting game for them to cook. And how long do you reckon it needs each side, providing the temperature's correct?
3.
About 3 minutes.
Going to flip it over once it's done.
Go on then.
That's good.
It worked. And I need to let it cook, okay? Don't flip it.
Next part, you have to put some sugar in, a tiny bit of sugar in your Welsh cake. So you get some sugar, that much, or a tiny bit bigger. Yeah, you need...
Depends how much sugar you like, I guess.
Yeah.
It's not good for your teeth.
If you need how much sugar you like, but I'll just do that much sugar.
Go on then, and then just gently sprinkle it on top.
Yeah, so you take it off. Like that.
You might want a bit more, maybe, over here?
Okay. I'm just going to try this. Did go down half this? Yum, 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 yum.
Is it good, yeah? Thumbs up.
These girls are Santa.